Hi everyone, welcome to my channel. In previous two different videos, we have seen how we can do auto ED using pandas profiling or using SweetWiz package. Both of these packages are quite handy when you want to quickly explore your data using just one or two line of code and get kind of a report or summary which represent distribution of all the variables, their correlations, their density plots, your missing values, everything. So a quick analysis you can do using those two packages. If you have not yet visited those videos, you can check out these videos in the link given above. Today we are going to discuss one more package which helps us to automatically visualize our data set. So the package which we are using today is AutoWiz package. First of all, we need to install the package if it is not already done. To install the package, the command is very simple, pip install AutoWiz. Once the installation is done, we first of all need to import AutoWiz class from this package's AutoWiz module. So for that we need to use this import statement from AutoWiz.AutoWiz class, import AutoWiz class. And after we have imported that, we need to create or we need to initialize the class using AutoWiz underscore class. So I'm just giving it a very short name, AV. After we have created the class, now we can visualize any data set. So to visualize the data set, you might use the data set, load the data set using pd.read.csv or other methods which use any kind of file. Here I am visualizing a data set directly from this URL. And this is basically the housing data set. So this is a data set of housing prices, and you can see it's a CSV file where the separator is comma separated file, right? So this is the URL of the file. First of all, what I need to do is av.autowiz. This is the function which we are going to use to create the visualization, and inside that we need to give the path. So this is the file path. If you have already loaded the file in your environment, you can give the data name here. And we need to mention what's the separator. I think the default separator is already comma. If it is not, you can change it. And you can mention if your file contains the target variable or not. As of now, I am just leaving it blank, no dependent variable. Header equal to 1 or header equal to 0 if your file have headers or if your file don't have headers. So you can see in this data we already have headers, right? So we can write header equal to 1. And there are few more arguments. You can leave it by default, and if you want you can change it. We will see. As of now I am leaving all the arguments as default. Let me run it and I'll also show you. This verbose equal to 0. You might have seen this verbose argument. It's it basically represents how you want to see your output, how many things you want to see in your output. We will talk about different options. We have verbose 0, 1 and 2, right? And chart format, we are not changing it. It is SVG, maximum rows analyzed. So suppose the data set is very large and you don't want to create charts for the entire data set. So you can give this argument maximum row analyze. By default its value is quite large. If you don't change this argument, by default it is going to analyze these many rows. And maximum columns to be analyzed, it is by default 30. If you want, you can change the number of columns, right? So when we have run this command, you have noticed that here I have used verbose equal to 0. Next time we will use verbose equal to 1 to see what's the difference between the output. So let me just see what all things it has generated. So we need to drag so many charts. Let me drag quickly. So little bit zooming. I hope you are able to read it. So it says that shape of the data is 20,000 something rows and 10 columns. So definitely it's going to analyze the entire data set, because maximum row analyzed and maximum column analyzed are quite larger than this. Classifying variables in the data set. When we are using verbose equal to 0, it just tells us how many predictors are there and if it includes the target column or not. if it remove any columns, if we have any ID columns or low information variable which cannot be used to create valid graph, so it remove that column. So no variable removed here as we don't have any ID or low information variable. Number of all scatter plots generated, it's 45. I think because we have 10 columns and scatter plot is basically a plot between two variables at a time. So 10 C2 is 45. Time to run this auto visualization is 8.38 seconds. And you see here, it's basically a table which shows the first few and last few entries. So first five rows you can see here, which we usually get by head and tail command. The last few rows are here. Now let me browse the plots. So first of all, pairwise scatter plot of all continuous variable, because we have not mentioned what is the target variable. So it is using all the pairs one by one. First latitude, longitude, and then housing median, age and longitude. So in the order in which we have the data in our file, it is creating all those scatter plots. So it is going to create 45 scatter plots. Let me quickly scroll down. All these scatter plots you can read. Then it creates histograms, KDE plots of all continuous variables. So you might be knowing that for continuous variable we can create density plots and histogram to know more about the this shape of the distribution. So these are the density plot for continuous variable. First of all, it is for total bedrooms, it is for households, and so on. So you can read and you can see the shape of the distribution. You can find out the outliers or skewness. It's the distribution of ocean proximity, top 15 categories only. So it is basically a categorical variable, and if in your categorical variable you have more than 15 categories, then it is going to show up to top 20, 15 categories. But because in this data set we just have 5 categories, so it is showing all these 5 categories. We are not seeing anything here on island because because frequency of this category is very low as compared to all these. You can check value counts in the data set and you will get to know. So these are all different density plots, and after this it also produced the Wallin plots of continuous variable in case you are interested. So these are all Wallin plots for all continuous variable. Finally, we have heat map, which helps us to identify the correlation, positive, negative, or how strong the correlation is between all the variables. So yeah, reading that might be, because I have zoomed in a lot, so you can't see it in one go. So you can zoom out and you can actually read it better to understand more. Average longitude by ocean proximity, average latitude by ocean proximity. So now what it is doing, it is plotting all the continuous variable, their distribution for different categories of the categorical variable, right? So these kind of column charts you can see, all different kind of charts it has automatically created in just one line of command, right? And this is the output when you have used verbose equal to 0. You can change verbose equal to 1 and see what happens. You can change the number of rows analyzed to be a lesser number to reduce the time, to just quickly check what happens. And let me show you verbose equal to 1. So basically I have also mentioned these notes here, that if you use verbose equal to 1, it print messages and also display the charts. Verbose equal to 0 does not print messages about the details of the variables. Actually this these comments are taken from the packet's GitHub page. They have mentioned that if you use verbose equal to 2, it will not display chart, it will simply save them. So I have just changed verbose equal to 1, nothing else we have changed. So let me go back to the top and we will see what's the difference. It should show us little more information. Yeah, we can see here. So obviously it is showing us the shape of the distribution, and it is giving little more information about the type of different columns. So number of numeric columns are 9 here, integer categorical column nothing, string categorical, factor categorical. So there is just one categorical column, which is a string categorical column. Ocean proximity is the categorical column. I hope you are aware about what are categorical columns and can we have different data types in categorical columns. If you are not, write it in the comment box. I will answer that. And Boolean columns, all these things, date time columns, everything. So nothing else. 10 predictors classified, and data set column info. Yeah, this is one more information it is giving us. that for longitude, no null values, 844 unique values, and most common values are this. Similarly, we can see for housing median age, there is no null value, 52 unique values, and most common values are this. So we can get an idea about if we have missing value in a particular column, or if we have very few unique values in that column, we might want to consider that column as a discrete or a categorical variable. So all these kind of information, columns to delete, how many boolean, percentage, continuous variable, all these are continuous variable, and it's showing us all the names and everything. Rest of the things are same, basically it is producing all those same plots. And it might have also shown in the beginning the time taken to create all these plots, and in the last it has shown these first few and last few rows. Time taken this time was 24.776 seconds. And if we want, we can specify the dependent variable also. So this time we are just using the same code with one additional argument, dependent variable. And dependent variable here is median housing house value. So this time it will produce the same information, same chart. Just I'm trying to show that when it knows that this is the target variable, so on top of the report it will show the scatter plot with respect to the dependent variable, so that you get an idea about how your target variable varies with respect to your predictors. You can see here the first few charts, scatter plot of each continuous variable against the target variable. So first few charts are always against the target variable. Y-axis is always median house value, and on x-axis you have different predictors. Rest of the things are same. So you can explore this library to quickly get visualizations. I would also like to show you one quick thing, that when you type AutoWiz in Google, you find first two links which are related to AutoWiz. This is basically the welcome page of this particular library. We will see that. And this is the GitHub page of this library. Let me show you the GitHub page here. So it's here. And you can see all the information for this library, the README file, table of contents, the information how to install this library, uses API and all those things. So the example here is also given, and these are all the arguments which you can use, and this is the information which I was showing, that verbose equal to 0, 1, 2, what messages are print, and these are the arguments which you use, maximum rows analyzed or maximum column analyzed. So whenever you start working on a new library or package, if you want to understand more about that library, either you should read the documentation of that library, or you should go to the GitHub page of that library. It helps you to understand more about that library, right? And this link, if you click on autowiz.io, you will get to this page, basically the home page of AutoWiz. And here you see you can create automatic visualization directly by using this page. What you need to do is enter a separator or delimiter that separates the column in your file. So if you are using a comma separated file, that's okay, the default separator is comma. If you are using a tab delimited file, or if the separator in your file is semicolon or something else, so you can change it here, whatever you want, by typing from your keyboard. And here you can upload your file. So you can upload your file by browsing it from your local machine where you have saved that file, and you can enter your email address. So this AutoWiz package will create the all possible visualization and send the visualization to your email address, right? So if you want, you can use that also to quickly get your visualization done. But I believe using the code is better, because we can change the data, we can change all those arguments which you want to do. But yeah, this is one more thing which I wanted to show you. And definitely you can see the sample of data visualization for all these popular data sets which all the beginners have worked with, Titanic and Iris and all. So if you click on any particular data set, you can see it asks you to get started with the plots. First of all, a scatter plot. So it has created a scatter plot of each continuous variable against the target variable. So in this, they might be knowing the target variable, which is survived. You might have used the Titanic data set, whether the passenger is survived or not. So P class, age, and all those variables are plotted against survived. and you can click here to look at pair scatter. You can click here to look at the histograms of all those variables, and you can look at the boiling plot for p class, age and everything. You can look at the distribution of the target variable, so whether the data is balanced or not, you can get an idea about this. You can look at the heat map and look at the bar chart and everything. So this is just a sample what all samples are available here, and you can request them to visualize your data set and send the report to your mail. That can be done. If you don't want to browse those and run that one line of code, that can be done. There is nothing in the blog, and there are some options in the premium version you can always explore. I hope you find it useful. Thank you for watching.